Cradle. Okay, they've added systems, but we've gone to two of these already. Lanal. A few planets. Laconix. Laconix is far enough from its F-class star that its temperatures are almost tolerable to sapient life, but its extremely thin atmosphere makes it almost as hostile as a vacuum. As such, the planet was uninhabited. Mining drones, piloted from orbital stations, would brave the high gravity to extract iridium, osmium, and other valuable heavy metals. The Reapers did not overlook Laconix in their sweep of the system, and the orbital stations are now destroyed. Those metal bastards. Triginta Petra. Interesting name. A low-density planet in comparison to Earth, Triginta Petra is also drier, with wide land masses that are largely desert. Its dextrochirality native life has yet to make it out of the oceans, primarily producing cyanobacteria which produce a limited amount of oxygen in the atmosphere. A handful of Turians colonized the planet and attempted to introduce land plants. Their chief hurdle was the lack of good topsoil, which required imports and sophisticated farming practices to overcome. The farmer's maxim on Triginta Petra was, if you can last 5 seasons, you officially know what you're doing. Preliminary scans of Triginta Petra suggest that the Reapers judged its population too low to harvest and struck its colonies with kinetic impactors. They then move on. Did I say struck? Struck its colonies. They then moved on, trusting that the destruction of the food supply's main arteries would finish off the inhabitants of such a biota-poor world. Capital is Lysitron, colony founded in 2120. Population 35,500. Pre-invasion, of course. And third from the sun is this little thing. Choitadix? Choitadix? A dwarf planet, Choitadix is notable for gold deposited by an asteroid strike that, geologically speaking, happened fairly recently. Surveyors suspected Choitadix was once larger but was reduced in size by the strike, which knocked enough material out of the planet to create misshapen moonlets. Its name, which means gap-toothed in a common Turian language, was retroactively added once scientists confirmed this hypothesis. It appears the pulverized orbital stations here were abandoned as a preemptive move before the Reapers reached the cluster. The fate of the refugees is unknown. If they fled to Triginta Petra, the outlook is particularly poor. And fourth and final planet. Nutus. Nutus is a hydrogen-helium gas giant with high nitrogen. Hydrogen-helium gas giant with high nitrogen content. It had several colonized moons. Nutus's moon Etrat was home to the small-time Terminus Systems warlord Rashtik Chass, who exacted tribute from the colonist on Triginta Petra and any travelers stopping by to refuel on Helium 3. Rashtik's small navy appears to have fled to safer pastures in advance of the Reaper invasion. I wonder if we had to deal with this warlord at some point. Stuff.
I found something.
Cool. Wow. We might not get another full scan. I mean, we'll get a scan, but they might invade at that point. Right here. Probe away. Search unsuccessful. Scans of the planet's surface show no signs of Leviathan's energy signature. Continue your search.
No sign of Leviathan at these coordinates.
Yes. Such I have heard. And there's another thing here somewhere. I'm gonna try to listen to the sound. Since the next scan... might bring them here. I mean, it could be on another planet. But these have always worked out to be one planet and one random area of space. I thought that was it for a second. I don't know where it might be. We gotta go.
Faster than light jump successful.
We have to check Lanao later. Let's go to Mill. Acrea. Tidally locked to its parent star, Mill, Acrea is a small rock planet that never bore much development due to the Asari on Chalkos and Selvos having limited resources and instead focusing their efforts on more welcoming worlds. Old scans indicate that it may have an abundance of nickel. Well, we don't need that. Lasir. Lasir is a low-density world notable for its appearance in the Asari exploitation... Asari exploitation, Holo Blue Steel, one of humanity's first attempts to market entertainment galactically. The promotional campaign assured viewers that it was filmed on location in the most dangerous section of the galaxy, the Terminus Systems. In fact, the cast and crew were relatively safe, occupying a space station, that orbited an unremarkable, lifeless planet. Lasir's space stations housed a largely Asari crew teleoperating a robo-mining of uranium. When Blue Steel was released, human audiences still thought of this as an exotic profession. Today, it would induce yawns. The Reapers have destroyed the orbital stations around Lasir and have moved on. It is not known that anyone managed to escape. Those bastards. Chalkos. Chalkos is notable for being one of a few garden worlds in the Milky Way that is also part of a binary planet system. Both it and its heavenly twin Selvos are in a stable orbit with one another, in addition to orbiting the star Mill. Chalkos's greenhouse gases lead to a hotter climate than Earth, and the solar eclipses caused by Selvos, while common, are not frequent enough to be a good solar shade. This did not prevent a colony from springing up, largely Asari and their varying species of mates. It was far from an idyllic settlement. Like many Terminus worlds, it was rife with farmers growing psychoactive substances, armed gangs, and with genetic engineering that would be illegal in Council space. But aside from the maddening heat and photo period, it was quite inhabitable. The Reapers turned Chalkos to rubble. Emergency broadcasts caught in a light cone coming from the planet indicate that the Reapers used ground forces to invade and spent little time harvesting. As they departed, the Reapers bombarded the planet from Earth, either because they needed to reinforce another front quickly or had gathered the data on genetic engineering they needed. Orbital distance, barycenter? 1.15 AU. I don't know, I started reading this because I saw this word barycenter. It's new. New to me, anyway. And Selvos? Chalcos' binary twin is a barren world that's always seemed like a better terraforming prospect than it is. Its temperatures are quite tolerable for sapient life, and its gravity is suitable for retaining a thick atmosphere. Its location, close to Chalcos, makes for a tempting investment. Two garden worlds so close together would benefit from mutual trade and, if nothing else, tourism due to their near unique status. However, Selvos has minimal water. Early attempts at creating a hydrosphere met with slow progress that only Chalcos' Asari could love. The deaths of the colonists on Selvos and Chalcos have dashed any hope for terraforming in the near future. Selvos is now a wasteland of punctured domed habitats, and its orbital stations are slag. The Reapers have moved on. How sad. Check this, belt. Sometimes there are goodies within. Oh, like that. This looked like one of the stars in the background. My lassie! A silicaceous asteroid, Mylassie is rich in olivine and pyroxene. The Asari colonizing Chalcos set up habitats on Mylassie, mostly to oversee a large-scale project in which smaller asteroids would be flown to Chalcos. There, the olivine would be recovered and used in sequestering the planet's carbon dioxide. As with many Asari projects, this was expected to take decades or centuries before generating an appreciable effect on the planet's climate. The station here has been bombarded by the Reapers. The effect on the integrity of the asteroid is unknown, but it does not appear to be breaking apart just yet. We've also got another planet to see. Which is this gas giant. Terrapso. A hydrogen-helium gas giant with an abundance of nitrogen in its atmosphere, Terrapso is notable because of the independence from the government of Chalcos as well as from any other governing body of its independence. As a result, its colonized moons and orbital stations overseeing the helium-3 recovery were neutral meeting grounds for all manners of deals between Terminus governments, warlords, or crime figures. The Reapers appear to have cursorily bombarded many of the moons and machinery here. It's possible there are survivors. No plans exist detailing the extensive tunnel networks that were under the moon's surfaces, but it's likely that without rescue or food shipments, any inhabitants will die off soon. So that's a good candidate as well, but let's scan these two at once. Nope. Reaper's not becoming aware.
Signal confirmed.
Chalcos. Probe launched. Husk neural map. Interesting.50% recovered. Well, since these are not becoming aware of us. Some fuel? Or my lassie? Scanning this tiny thing. Probe launched. Search unsuccessful, etc.
No sign of Leviathan at these coordinates.
Well, the game is probably set up that wherever we go, it's going to be the last one we check anyway. That's what I'm thinking. But we are low on fuel. We need to go back and get some fuel. And then we'll go to Sai Tofei or whatever. Unfortunately, I keep having to go to another system to get fuel. It's so annoying.
Signal confirmed.
Where's he heading? Give me that fuel. Yeah, instead of finding fuel, we're finding stuff where, you know, yeah, the Reaper's not, I mean, the Leviathan's not here. Engage. So this last system here. It's gotta be here, mister. We got three planets. 2181 Despoina. This planet was only spotted recently by human space probes, and no records indicate it has been explored since. Scans indicate it is covered in an ocean of liquid water and has a nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere. It is highly likely to have at least some photosynthetic life. I think I remember these planets. They all had numbers like that. 2181 Arian. Like from the previous game. This rock planet is only known from space probes and there are no records of its exploration. It appears to have a moderate atmosphere of hydrogen and helium over an icy surface. And finally, 2181 Eubolos. Like the other planets in this system, 2181 Eubolos is an unknown quantity. It appears to be a hydrogen-helium gas giant surrounded by the usual complement of moons and rings. Scans reveal no detectable artificial satellites. Time to scan right between these two planets.
I found something.
It's gotta be here, mister. Probe away. Oh. Search successful. Scans reveal a faint trace of Leviathan's energy signature. Closer examination required for confirmation.
These coordinates match our trace of Leviathan.
Alright, so we can land. Oh, that's the only thing in the system. Cool. Alright, so we're gonna land. Okay, I told you guys we'd bring 80 and 70 R this time. Been a while since we took anyone other than these two. Not changing loadout. I have 4 points. Can I increase Nova? No. Edia has some points. Incinerate. Health and armor. Shields, barriers, and synthetics. Yeah, let's take this. Let's max this out. Increase damage to frozen and chilled targets by an additional 100%. But that, of course, they have to be frozen and or chilled. Increased damage to armored targets. Let's do that. And Javik, we can't increase anything. The little shuttle that could...
Cortez, what's the status on the probe we launched?
Tracking it now, Commander. I've confirmed that Leviathan's signal originates from this planet. Heard how, Anne helped us locate it. It's pretty spooky stuff.
Hmm. Given the circumstances, what are we expecting to find down there?
Dr. Bryson classified Leviathan as a Reaper killer. It appears it doesn't wish to be found.
Nope.
Doesn't have a choice. We're here.
Yes, but then what? If this is a Reaper, how can we ally ourselves with it? They are monsters, never to be trusted.
Oh, we're not making friends, necessarily.
Nobody says we have to be friends with it, but if this thing has the rest of the Reapers worried, then we need its help.
Commander, new readings from the probe. It's narrowed down Leviathan's location. You're not gonna like it.
Uh-oh.
There's nothing but ocean. I show a concentration of structures floating on the surface, but the probe's giving us a signal below that. Way below.
Huh.
Underwater.
It is Loch Ness Monster.
The shuttle should still be able to reach it.
So this is like Leviathan the movie that took place underwater.
Kodiak is spec to nearly 1,000 atmospheres, but I've never actually tested that.
Guess we're gonna find out.
Whoops.
Status!
Some kind of pulse hit us! Systems are shutting down!
It's pulsing us. Are we landing in the water? Oh. Damn. That's a fine how do you do?
Everyone all right?
I've survived far worse, Commander.
How's the shuttle, Cortez?
Checking now. I'll see if I can get power restored.
Copy that. We'll look around.
It would seem others have been stranded here as well. We aren't the first to encounter that pulse.
Could be Leviathan's last line of defense.
Right. Like an EMP or something. Wait for shuttle repairs. The Normandy shuttle has been disabled by an unknown energy surge. Search for Leviathan and a way to escape the planet. I can't jump up there, I guess. I'm rolling them like crazy here. Pretty awesome though, look at that.
This is a place of death. Those ships look like they've been drifting for years.
Place of death. What stops them from sinking completely? I mean, we're not that deep in the water here. Oh, there's a thingy over here. Pure Ezo samples? 2250 credits. Oh, someone left an assault rifle Omni Blade around here. Number 3, M55 Argus. Cool, it's an assault rifle. It's heavy. The Argus is a high-powered rifle favored by senior CSEC officers. An excellent close-range weapon, its bursts of fire ensure ammunition conservation during lengthy conflicts. Other law enforcement agencies across the galaxy are adopting the Argus as their standard rifle, as much for its intimidation factor as an suppression power. Well, it is heavy. Higher capacity, fire rate. The damage isn't that much better. And accuracy sucks, so why the hell would I change that? Yeah. Alright, we got something else over here. Data pad.
Look, up there!
Reapers, Commander! They were right behind us!